Hello everyone, Justin Vacula here with yet another video in my Stoic Philosophy series titled Stoicism and Healthy Vegetarian Lifestyle. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and my website at justinvacula.com. Links are in the video description. My Stoic Philosophy video series explores the philosophical tradition of Stoicism with goals to inform, empower, and help others benefit from the practical wisdom of ancient Greek, Roman, and modern thinkers. I tackle many topics, including handling adversity, finding meaning in life, working toward contentment, dealing with change, anger, and gratitude. In recent years, following a healthy vegetarian diet, regular exercise, and various mindset changes I'll talk about in this video, I went from about 300 pounds to sustaining 170 pounds. People ask about how I lost weight and which changes I've made to my life, so I'll take some time to talk about my personal reflections and offer words of wisdom from Stoic philosopher Seneca. During my years in high school, I lived a mostly sedentary lifestyle without exercise, without concern for what I was eating, and viewed consumption of food as a mainly pleasurable activity, frequently eating out with family members, consuming lots of food at home, and having little to no concern or mindfulness about what I was doing. Perhaps the most exercise I had was in mandatory gym classes in school and occasional hikes in the scouting program. In undergraduate education, many of the same patterns continued, especially being at college, which served buffet-style meals. Working in food service allowed me to eat large meals, many of which I could prepare. Still, exercise wasn't a concern. Toward the end of my undergraduate education and the beginning of grad school, I started to think about arguments against eating meat concerning animal suffering, environmental impact, and health. I won't get into these arguments too much in detail here, but could touch on them in the future. I thought it'd be difficult to abstain from meat eating, but viewed this as a challenge and proceeded to successfully eliminate meat from my diet for the most part through a cold turkey approach. Eventually, I did the same with seafood and most dairy products. Even when living with family members who were quite negative about these changes, making comments about how my decisions were dumb or making statements like, "You need to eat meat, that's just what you should do." Arguments about having to prepare extra food for me even though I could cook my own food. Oh well, I'll be content with my own decisions and not put too much stock into people being harsh about my choices, rather than having a more intellectual discussion, even if people insist I eat what they prepare and they don't make an alternative meal. Perhaps in protest, I don't know. Well, I began to exercise, to have more space to myself, to listen to podcasts on the go, rather than sitting in front of a computer screen or just laying down while listening. Technology's a nice thing. We've come far from the days of having to carry a laptop around or different things, iPads, iPods. I started to study and learn about poker and became convinced by arguments that exercise, weight loss, and a more healthy lifestyle would lead to better performance at the tables and have other benefits. So, a healthier lifestyle leading to more money? Well, that's quite the motivation. I'm on board. When living with roommates, friends, I completely prepared my own food, and it was even easier to exclude meat and seafood from my diet. I continue to exercise simply walking long distances with my phone, podcasts in hand, or pocket. The weight loss was beginning, and I eventually opted to enroll at Planet Fitness to have a more structured workout focused on weight loss. I continue to exercise now, about 2.5 years later, particularly before I start poker sessions. Exercise is fun for me, as I typically blast metal music with my earbuds and work toward my goals. It allows for more balance, structure, and good use of my time, too, in life. Now I'm dedicating myself to an activity on a regular basis. I have a simple routine of cardio and strength training machines established by a gym staff. Headbanging on the treadmill, it's more likely than you think. While at home, I eat a simple breakfast, which includes a banana and a protein shake, whey powder, oats, almond milk, and water. Lunch is typically brown rice, Brussels sprouts or carrots, sometimes hummus, an apple, and a protein bar. Dinner is usually a selection of fruit, including mangoes, strawberries, oranges, berries, and grapes with a protein bar, and sometimes hot oatmeal too, later in the day. I also take iron and B12 supplements and have 2 protein shakes while at the gym, just powder with water, before and after exercise. I find this routine simple, cost-effective, sustainable, and healthy. I rarely eat at restaurants, and when I do, it's almost never by myself. It's a social occasion, like meeting a friend who is in the area, or spending time with a family member. Even then, I keep the cost around $10 to $15 for myself and try to order healthy options, pick venues which offer vegetarian options, and maintain discipline. Perhaps I'm on the go at a conference, but I can bring food with me in most situations, and I can have 1 or 2 hot meals at restaurants. Usually, healthy options are available. No big deal. I spend little and really don't find the eating experience so appealing. people talk about food as tasting good. They talk about spending $60 on a steak and enjoying it, buying desserts, having really large meals, and constantly eating. They order pizza or fast food on a frequent basis. This just doesn't move me. This conversation about food being so good and people having extreme cravings for food, this is alien to me now. Food I used to eat, like French fries and burgers, are completely out of the question. Sure, once in a while, okay, I can have a snack or eat something not so great like a salted soft pretzel as a matter of convenience, but I even work to cut back on that, and instead have peanuts, more fruit, or something preferable. Something healthier. Maybe on the go, well, some tortilla chips that are provided when not much is available, well, okay, not the end of the world. Meat and seafood, well, I really don't miss it. Perhaps this was a habit. I grew up around people who ate these things and associated food so much with pleasure. But I've worked to change my mindset to lose weight, live a more ethical lifestyle, save money, and be more content with less. As an adult with so many choices, my own car, internet delivery services, well, I can resist the temptation and cook at home with groceries I purchase at my local supermarket. Call it boring? Well, I'd prefer a healthier lifestyle and more money in my pocket for other activities I can find enjoyable and fulfilling. Again, I don't view eating in itself as a pleasurable experience. You know, that eat-to-live attitude rather than a live-to-eat mentality. Perhaps many eat at restaurants or fast food locations as a matter of laziness or convenience. They simply don't want to take the time to prepare and clean. Perhaps they have busy work days or feel exhausted. Well, surely some time can be put into managing your schedule, and at least my lunch and breakfast routine takes about 45 minutes. I can even purchase more ready-to-eat items if I wanted to save even more time, take things on the go with me. One can combine cooking and prep, too, with listening to podcasts, YouTube videos, browsing the internet, chats with friends, and engaging yourself with other tasks to be more time efficient, to multitask. Surely we're limited in time, and this I don't have the time can be a quick excuse, but have many really sat down to really evaluate their schedules or even think about a schedule? How much downtime, or shall we say wasted time, do we find ourselves partaking in each day? Do we keep a log of our time or plan our days? Perhaps people would be really surprised to see how much dead time they have throughout the day. Even if genuinely limited on time, well, you may still spend money eating out, but can surely cut KFC and pizza out of the equation. Some might want to save time. They find this convenience. They don't really want to spend the time on the meal and prep. And okay, I can understand that. Their time is valuable, so be it. But even then, you could still have this healthier option if that's the way you want to go. The philosopher Seneca has some words about mindset and living a more minimalist, modest lifestyle to work toward contentment. He writes in his letter, in letter number 5, on the philosopher's mean. Let us try to maintain a higher standard of life than that of the multitude, but not a contrary standard. Otherwise, we shall frighten away and repel the very persons whom we are trying to improve. We also bring it about that they are unwilling to imitate us in everything, because they are afraid lest they might be compelled to imitate us in everything. So, it's not a good thing to lack a self-reflective character by merely resembling those around us, not questioning the eating or spending habits of others, perhaps not directly to them, but internally, wondering about whether these habits are good ones. Do I want to do this? What are the people doing around me? Stoicism does not advocate for an extreme aesthetic lifestyle and having no possessions, no pleasure, and living in poverty, but rather a sensible balance seems to be preferred. Living well and making ethical choices, some of which in the modern day can surely improve our eating habits given, as I mentioned, concerns about the environment and suffering animals face, especially in the crowded factory farms and slaughter facilities. Shall we be so enthusiastically participating in the massive environmental costs which come with raising a high quantity of animals engineered for slaughter and consumption, when we can instead opt out of these practices and have a more sustainable vegetarian lifestyle? Maybe it can be difficult to break habits and change won't happen overnight, but some gradual changes can happen amidst self-reflection, especially when we have so many options to abstain from consuming animal products at low cost. Seneca continues in his letters. Our motto, as you know, is live according to nature. But it is quite contrary to nature to torture the body, to hate unlabored elegance, to be dirty on purpose, to eat food that is only plain, but disgusting and forbidding. Just as it is a sign of luxury to seek out dainties, so it is madness to avoid that which is customary and can be purchased for no great price. Philosophy calls for plain living, not for penance. Our life should observe a happy medium between the ways of a sage and the ways of the world at large. So, living an unhealthy lifestyle, well, we can be thoughtful. We can work to break habits. We can work to change our mindset, but not be so extreme in the process to make some changes, to work toward goals we can set for ourselves, make gradual changes, rather than seeking out lavish or expensive meals, especially unhealthy foods, at least on a frequent basis, we can work to curb our desires and have more moderation, more balance in our lives to use our money for other means, perhaps even healthier options. Seneca continues in letter 8 titled On the Philosopher's Seclusion. He writes, "Hold fast then to the sound and wholesome rule of life, that you indulge the body only so far as it is needful for good health. The body should be treated more rigorously, that it may not be disobedient to the mind. Eat merely to relieve your hunger, drink merely to quench your thirst." Here's more urging for a minimalist lifestyle, not overeating, not overdoing it, not drinking to excess, but being mindful, being healthy. Seneca too sees eating for sustenance rather than pleasure being a primary or even major focus. All right, thanks for watching and stay tuned for more content. This video obviously could be much longer, but I'm keeping it around that 10 to 15 minute mark. These are some big topics, but I welcome your feedback below, your thoughts on the video. I will also offer one resource external to Stoic philosophy concerning environmental issues about consuming animal products and animal suffering, the documentary Cowspiracy, which is available for streaming on Netflix and in other venues. The film also explores concerns about animal suffering and environmental organizations' failure to consider a vegetarian lifestyle and highlight the costs of factory farming, in addition to examining agricultural industries' political influence. You can also listen to the film's producers on the Joe Rogan Experience podcast. Links for that are below. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and my website at justinvacula.com. Links are in the video description. Please subscribe, share, comment, and like the video if you find my contribution worthwhile. Watch earlier videos on this channel in which I explore perspectives within Stoic philosophy that can help improve your quality of life. Consider donating if you support my work and would like to see more, for this takes time and effort to produce content. I'll soon be uploading videos concerning gratitude from my March 2017 discussion group with the Humanist Association of Greater Philadelphia, and a companion video compiling my notes from the discussion. I also plan to address some criticisms of my approach to Stoic philosophy through a non-religious perspective offered by a former philosophy professor of mine whose opinions I value. I hope you enjoyed this video. I seek to add more scripted videos like this one and to improve my video quality through using different approaches and learning how to better create YouTube content, although my time can be quite limited given other obligations. It's a big process. All right, have a good day. Stay tuned for more. Thank you.